We take for granted the idea that we'll be able to slide around on snow forever, but we won't. And that we're already losing that ability in place after place after place. And so those of us who love winter now have to stand up for it as never before. If we go on as we're going at the moment, if we don't take really serious steps to deal with climate change, then winter will be confined to the highest latitudes and the highest elevations. The good news is that what we have to do is fairly straightforward. We have to stop burning coal and gas and oil. There's no longer a technological or financial obstacle to doing it. The obstacles are inertia, which is always a force in human affairs, and vested interest. We have an enormous industry, the fossil fuel industry, that wants to keep its business model alive. And they have enough money and power politically to, well, to prevent change from happening. That's why we have to build the movements that make change happen and make it happen fast. Mostly, I've gone to jail fighting plans of the fossil fuel industry to keep expanding. The scientists have told us now for more than a decade that we have no more room to expand pipelines and fracking wells and all the other things that go with fossil fuel, and yet they keep doing it. What our sporting heroes and others can do is become involved in what are unavoidably political fights. They can stand up to the fossil fuel industry. But what really matters is if the people that people admire and look up to say, we'll have nothing to do with Exxon and Chevron and BP and Shell and Gazprom and Lukoil and all the rest. To those of us who really value winter, we need to understand that we may be the last generation that really gets to enjoy winter unless we act now to stand up to the fossil fuel industry. We've got to get outside our comfort zone, whatever that means, going to jail, standing up to sponsors, giving more money than one wants to. We've got to be outside our comfort zone because the planet is way outside its comfort zone. That's what the pouring rain after the opening ceremonies for these games really should have signaled to us, that the time has come to act.